many lectures in this lesson, and if you remember, I have already finished these lectures. So students, what we have learnt in this lesson we have learnt about the various revolutions that have played an important role in the improvement of crops, and then we have learnt what are the various nutrients that we get when we eat, when we feed on variety of crops. Then we have learnt about the crops, about the different seasons in which the crops are grown. They may be a kharif crop and it may be a rabi crop. So a farmer should have a knowledge that whether the crop is kharif or rabi crop, and accordingly the farmer can sow the crop in the field, right? Then in this lesson we have learnt about that farmer and any person who is concerned with crop improvement, who is concerned with growing of crops or storing, should have knowledge what are the different nutrients which the plants take by the water, by the air, or by means of soil. So we should have the knowledge of macro and micronutrient. Then we have seen the various ways by which crop improvement can be done, like hybridization and genetic modification. Then we have also learnt about the various factors for which crop variety improvement is being done, like improving the crop for a better resistant variety for diseases. Then we have seen that we should also improve the crop variety so that they are resistant to a variety of diseases. They can face or they can tolerate different climates of India. Then we have also learnt, if we have moved further, when we have moved further in this lesson, then we have also learnt about the different ways by which we give water to the plant, or I am talking about the methods of irrigation, the different methods of sources of water which are available in India and by which we can give water to the agricultural field so that we can have a maximum output from a small area or a piece of land. Then we have learnt about the different cropping patterns. From the same area, what are the different ways or what are the different patterns by which if we can grow crop, we can get a more output. So there we have learnt about mixed cropping. Then we have learnt about crop rotation, and we also have learnt about intercropping. Okay student, then we have learnt about harvesting, storing, and one more point that we have learnt, that if we have done everything for a good variety of crop and then suddenly there are spread of diseases in our crop, then what precaution we should know. So we have learned the various ways by which we can protect our crop. How can we use biopesticides or bioinsecticides so that our crops are not harmed and we get a good productivity. Then we have learnt the way, these were the topics that we have learnt for improving crop variety and for increasing the crop production. In addition to this, we have also learnt about animal husbandry, and I think you have received the module from the society up to crop variety improvement on crop production management, crop nutrient management. These all you have already received, and you are finished with your worksheets. So student, if you haven't, this is compulsory for you to please, we are requesting that please do the worksheet. And previously we have instructed you to do the worksheet in a same notebook, and for 9th class separate notebook should be for physics, chemistry and biology. Then we have also told you that worksheet should be done in the notebook. Okay, fine if you have done, but now recent document that you are receiving, from now whatever you do, please, whatever older work that you have done in your copy, it is good and fine, but whatever new work that you are going to do, we please insist you to do in fresh worksheet and loose paper, so that whenever we required, we can take from you. And all the students are already submitting worksheets by means of email, because they have joined Google Classroom, and there we can check your worksheet. So students, now you should start doing the worksheet if you haven't, because they are compulsory. You will be awarded marks for it, and they will be considered as the assignment. So it has been continuously said by the school, please do your worksheet. The links for worksheets are provided in your separate groups. So whenever you open that, fresh links are also given. Whenever you open, please download the worksheet, please do the answers. And if you are not able to do the answer of the worksheet, if you have any problem in the worksheet, please don't hesitate to answer to question us. So you can ask, so that we can clarify your doubt. But anyhow, you have to complete your worksheet. So there, the module that you have received, I think they will upload certain new modules regarding animal husbandry. But I have already finished animal husbandry, and there we have learnt about cattle farming, poultry farming, fish farming, and bee farming. So we have finished all the topics, and today I have brought certain important question that I feel is important, so that we can discuss it. So I have written the questions here. If you don't know the answer, I know that I have already explained, so you already know. But please be seated, and if you are present in the class, you have to say present ma'am, because your attendance is being continuously watched by the school, and it is being written here, so that we should know, we can get the knowledge, who are the students who are regularly watching and who are the students who are absent in the lecture. So as daily, attendance is marked in your school, similarly here also, when you sit to watch the video lecture, then you should say present ma'am or present sir to mark your attendance, and your attendance is being marked regularly. And if any student don't know this, please convey this message from our school, that you have to say present and you have to sit all along the video, so that you can get a proper knowledge about the lecture. So here you can see a question, how is fish meat advantageous than the meat of other animals? So as I have told you earlier, that fish meat, it has more amount of protein and less amount of fats. Therefore, it can be easily digested as compared to the other meats. It is a good source of vitamin A and K, and it also provides us with some salts like iodine. And iodine is very important for the proper functioning of thyroid gland and for the secretion of thyroxine hormone. So therefore, fish meat is advantageous meat as compared to the other animals. And one more reason is that fish meat is relatively cheaper than other meat, and it can be easily, you can easily get it from the market without any shortage, because there is plenty of fish meat available in the market. The next question is, what are the important precautions that should be taken in poultry farming? Students, if any single bird has an infection in the poultry, then there are chances that the disease from or the infection from one bird may spread to the entire community of the birds who are in the poultry. So proper ventilation should be there, and all the birds should be properly fed with the nutritious food. I have already explained you what are the different kinds of feeds which are given to the poultry. So accordingly, they are broiler or layer. Accordingly, different foods are given to them according to their requirement. Then the place there which where they are kept, it should have a proper lighting and proper temperature. It should not have a very low temperature, neither very high temperature, so that they cannot survive. So that condition should be maintained at that particular place, that they can easily live and have a proper diet. Then proper vaccination and timely vaccination. All the poultry birds, they are provided with vaccination, so that a disease may not happen. We will decrease their chances that the disease may happen in the poultry birds. So proper vaccination should be there, and the place where the birds are kept, that particular place should be free from pest and insect. So, and there should be proper cleaning, because they discharge their excreta also, and if they will be present at that particular place where the feed get mixed with the excreta, then the chances of spreading of disease will be more. So there should be regular cleaning of the place where they are kept. And if any poultry bird has a disease, then the bird should be kept separately and treated them separately, so that the disease don't spread to the other birds. The next question is, name a biopesticide. Biopesticide. Pesticide is a chemical which is used to control or decrease the growth of, to kill or decrease the growth of insect and pest which can harm a crop. Okay. And bio means any substance which has life in it. So any substance which has a living origin, that can be used as a biopesticide if it has the ability to kill or stop the growth of pest and insect. So neem is a popular biopesticide which can be used in place of chemical pesticides. The next one is, why do drought occur? So drought is the condition in which any particular area of the field or India or entire the world which don't receive rainfall for continuous period of years, and because of which the soil has become so dry that the growth of crop has been decreased, the animals have started dying, and people have started migrating from that particular place because of dryness. So the inavailability of rain in a particular area for many years is known as drought. So why do drought occur? You should know what are the reasons. Just think. Till then I drink some water. Just look to the reasons why do drought occur. Okay, student, I am back. Why do drought occur? As I have told you earlier in my previous lectures, that drought occurs due to non-availability of rain for many years, or improper rain distribution or monsoon distribution at a particular area. And you all know that in India, the agricultural field is dependent totally on monsoon. Means Indian farmers, a great percentage of Indian farmers depend on monsoon for fetching water to the, for giving water or for irrigating the field. So they wait for the monsoon season, and accordingly they prepare their field. And if there is no rain for a continuous period of time, then it decreases the productivity of the crop, and the farmer has to look to other options for getting water to the agricultural field. Okay, the next one is what is the main benefit of mixed cropping? Students, we have learnt three types of cropping patterns. One was mixed cropping, another was intercropping, and the third was crop rotation. So first one was mixed cropping. If you remember, in mixed cropping we have learnt that mixed cropping is a cropping pattern in two or more than two types of crop can be grown simultaneously in a area. There is no pattern followed. Okay, so the question is here, what is the main benefit? Why the farmer does this? The main benefit for this is that the farmer gets insurance that if a crop fails also, if one of the crop fails, then also the farmer gets the insurance that the farmer will get productivity from the other crop. The second, if both the crops are successful, then it will certainly improve the crop productivity, and the farmer can have a variety of crops in a particular area. So it decreases the failure rate of the crop, and the crop and the farmer will certainly get something from the field. So that is the main benefit of mixed farming or mixed cropping. Then the next one is, mention two signs of a healthy animal. Means, how can you know that the animal is healthy? The answer is similar as you know how your friend, by looking your friend, you can answer that the your friend is healthy or the your friend is sick. How can you know? If you talk to your friend, he or she will not respond in a particular manner. If you give food, the person will not, he will or she will say that I don't want to have food, I will eat afterwards. Or the body temperature has increased, or the voice may crackle, or the voice, the frequency will increase or decrease. And if the person is trying to walk, the person may be vary in his walk. So these are the signs that you see in your friend. Similarly, here also, if the animal is diseased, then by certain sign we can identify that the animal is non-healthy or the animal is ill. The first sign is that the animal will not have a normal posture. Means the animal will try to sit every time. So, and that too, the head will be towards down. The tail will be towards, means it, the tail will not move frequently. The legs will not move frequently. So the activity of the animal will decrease. The animal will stop feeding regularly, or will stop feeding for 1 or 2 days. So, if you check the body temperature, then also you may see that there is slight increase in the body temperature. So these are the signs by seeing you can easily identify whether a animal is healthy or diseased. The next one is, name the internal parasite which affect the stomach, intestine and liver in the cattle. Internal parasite is a parasite which lives inside the body, and external parasite is a parasite which lives outside the body. And parasites are the organisms which don't kill the host organism, but slowly and slowly takes the nutrition from their body, either by living inside or from outside, and makes the host organism weak. So this question basically asks for the internal parasites. Internal parasites, like there are worms which can live in the stomach or the intestine, and in the liver there is a parasite which is liver fluke. So fluke is the parasite which lives in the liver and which can cause infection, because of which the animal may fall sick. Then the next question is, why should beekeeping be done in a good pasturage? If you remember, I have included beekeeping in poultry, cattle farming. No, I have introduced, included beekeeping in poultry farming. So there I have told you that the quality of honey absolutely depend on the kind of pasturage. And pasturage is the place which has the variety of plants with flowers. So the honeybees collect nectar from different kind of flowers and take it to the beehive and convert it into honey. So now it is totally dependent on the pasturage. If it has a pasturage has a large area, then obviously the quantity of honey production will improve. And if the pasturage has a variety of plants, then its quality will also improve. So why should beekeeping be done in a good pasturage? To improve the quality as well as quantity of the honey production. Then the next one is, differentiate between compost and vermicompost. Students, compost, you all know that the process of making compost you have learnt in class 6. Same, I have also told you, you have learnt it in 8th class also. So many times you have learnt that for making compost, you have to make a you have to dig off soil from a big place, and you have to add the agricultural waste, the animal waste, the peels of vegetable and fruits, all these you can add there, and just sprinkle certain water and cover it by a big leaf. So all the biodegradable things you can add there and leave that for 1 month or 1.5 months. You will, after some time, when you will dig out certain amount of substance from there, you will see that the color has changed and the color has become to brown or black. So what you have, what is made in the compost, manure is made. So that is compost. And the question is, differentiate between compost and vermicompost. If the same procedure you follow by adding earthworm in it, now the compost that you make out of it will be your vermi, in which earthworm are used, and in compost we don't use earthworm. Both of them has a for formation of compost will be little higher as compared to vermicompost, because in vermicompost we have added earthworm, and earthworm will increase the rate of degradation of the biodegradable substance, and the vermicompost will form more earlier as compared to your compost. So this is the difference between a compost and vermicompost. Students, I have certain more questions. that I want to discuss. Some of the questions are, if you have any doubt, please post it so that by the end of lecture I can see it and your problem is solved. If you have any problem regarding the modules, worksheet or the previous lectures that we have done, that also you can ask that, ma'am, from this module I have not understood this part, so I will explain it again. So if you have any doubt, please post it. If you look from a certain distance, the color of water looks bluish. Okay, because of sky. So therefore blue revolution is meant for fish production. Green revolution is for wheat, rice and the grains. Then blue revolution is for fish, and yellow revolution is for the pulses. Okay, the next question is, an Italian bee variety A mellifera has been introduced in India for honey production. It's a very important question, so I am checking it again. An Italian bee variety A mellifera, A is for Apis, Apis is for honey. Apis mellifera has been introduced in India for honey production. The variety of bee which has been selected in India for honey production is Apis mellifera, and it has certain peculiar properties, characteristics. Distinctless means the person who are engaged in this business, because they are surrounded by honey. Their work is to collect honey, and honey is present in the beehive, so they have to deal with the bees also. So this Apis mellifera, it stinks less. Then the next is that it has high honey collection capacity. I have already told you. It stays in a given beehive for a longer duration of time. Means it will stay in its beehive for a long period of time. So because of these, okay, then question is, which one has more fat content, egg or meat? Just imagine, what is it, we get more amount of fat from egg or meat? Certainly we get more amount of fat from egg, and that is around 12%. Okay, then there's a question, name two sources of vitamin B2 and vitamin B12. The answer is milk and meat. From both you can get B2 and B12. The next question, what are milch animals? So milch are the animals from which we rear for getting milk production. So that are known as the milch. Student, this is another important question. I am repeating it again. Name two foreign cattle breeds that are selected for long lactation period. Lactation period, if you remember, it means the duration of time for which the animal gives, or the cattle gives milk after the birth of the calf. So if we anyhow improve the lactation period, the production of milk will automatically improve. So the question here is, you have to name, so the, see the diagram, the name of the foreign cattle breeds that are selected for long lactation period. Name two cattle breeds which show excellent resistance of diseases. Normally it has been seen that the exotic varieties, or the varieties which we have introduced from some other country in India, they are good in milk production. And the varieties of cattle that or poultry that are present in India, they have good resistance to disease. So the cattle breed from India, they are good in resistance. So that is resistant to diseases. So the names are Red Sindhi and Sahiwal. And then, sir. So the next one, the last question that I am going to take is, mention two science that I have already taken, I think. So if you have any question, just please answer, just please put in the comment box so that I can take it. There are many questions and I have already discussed you. If there are certain questions raised that left, we will take them in the next video. Sorry for the question. Okay, students, net is not working properly. You may have certain problems. I will see in the comment. Please leave your questions in the comment box and afterwards I will see your questions and accordingly I will answer it in group. And thank you. And in the next lectures, we will be ready either with the next module or with some more questions of this lesson. Till then, take care.